published 0840, est, the 22nd of November 2017, updated 1337, est, the 22nd of November 2017. Philip Hammond today promised to revive the home-owning dream in Britain as he unveiled a raft of proposals to boost house building. The Chancellor said he will pour £44 billion into funding and backing loans to build in 300,000 homes a year as he pledged to finally get a grip on the housing crisis. He axed stamp duty for first-time buyers on homes worth up to £300,000, and inside London the policy will apply to the first £300,000 of homes worth up to £500,000. The reforms mean 80% of first-time buyers would pay no stamp duty at all under the dramatic reforms. But the announcement, the centerpiece of Mr. Hammond's make-or-break budget, risked backfiring as experts said the stamp duty cuts will push up house prices. While young first-time buyers who have saved and scraped to recently buy their first home angrily demanded to know if they will get a refund on their stamp duty, Chancellor Philip Hammond today axed stamp duty for first-time buyers purchasing home worth up to £300,000. Government figures show that 217,350 new homes were added to the English housing stock in 201,617, 27,700 up on the previous year and the highest since the financial crash of 200,708. Mr. Hammond told MPs today, "When we said we would revive the home-owning dream in Britain, we meant it." Mr. Hammond hoped his promise to scrap stamp duty for most first-time buyers will woo millennials who had almost given up on the dream of owning their own home. Victims of the Grenfell Tower tragedy will get another £28 million of support. The Chancellor announced the victims of the Grenfell Tower tragedy will get another £28 million of support, Philip Hammond today said. The Chancellor said the cash will go on mental health and counselling services and regeneration in the West London neighbourhood. And he promised financial support for councils struggling to pay for safety repairs in the wake of the tragedy. He told MPs, "This tragedy should never have happened, and we must ensure that nothing like it never happens again." He added, "All local authorities and housing associations must carry out any identified, necessary safety works as soon as possible. And if any local authority cannot access funding to pay for essential fire safety work, they should contact us immediately. I have said before, and I will say again today, we will not allow financial constraints to get in the way of any essential fire safety work." But the Office for Budget Responsibility, the public spending WACOG, said the move will backfire as it will push up house prices and benefit current owners. It said the main gainers from the policy are people who already own property, not the first-time buyers themselves, and millennials who have just bought their first home and so narrowly missed out on the policy took to Twitter to demand a refund from the Chancellor. Monica Mojumdar-Chan wrote on Twitter, "Philip Hammond, we bought our house 6 months ago and paid 10k stamp duty. Do we get a refund? Budget 2017 and Orwood show me house in London for £300 kthe. Latest government figures show that 217,350 new homes were added to the English housing stock in 201,617, 27,700 up on the previous year and the highest since the financial crash of 2007-2008, Mr. Hammond said today, "We set out an ambitious plan to tackle the housing challenge. Over the next 5 years, we will commit a total of at least £44 billion of capital funding, loans and guarantees to support our housing market, to boost the supply of skills, resources, and building land, and to create the financial incentives necessary. It will deliver 300,000 net additional homes a year on average by the mid-2020s, the biggest annual increase in housing supply since 1970. Mr. Hammond said there was new money for the Home Builders Fund to get small house builders building again. He also said there would be a £630 million small sites fund to unstick the delivery of 40,000 homes and a further £2.7 billion to more than double the housing infrastructure fund. Mr. Hammond also announced plans to build 5 new garden towns in the Oxford Milton Keynes Cambridge corridor. And he announced a crackdown on empty homes by allowing local authorities to double the council tax charged on them, while an extra £28 million will be spent on tackling homelessness in the West Midlands, Manchester and Liverpool. and he announced plans to try to kick-start development by loosening planning laws to stop developers sitting on land banks. While the government will also consult at introducing new measures to create a minimum density for city housing projects, millennials who have recently coughed up thousands of pounds to pay their stamp duty on their first home expressed their anger at missing out on the budget giveaway Prime Minister Theresa May pictured on a visit to a housing estate in Edgware last week signalled last week she would take personal charge of the response to the housing crisis. Run-up to the budget was dominated by internal government splits on housing, amid claims Communities Secretary Sajid Javid wanted £50 billion in new borrowing. Prime Minister Theresa May is said to have vetoed proposals from Mr. Hammond to loosen rules on building on the Green Belt. The government announced last week that housing association debt was being taken off the balance sheet. The accounting change, which it is believed will give a stable investment environment to fund new homes, Mrs. May signaled last week she would take personal charge of the response to the housing crisis during a visit to a housing estate in North London. For decades, we simply have not been building enough homes, nor have we been building them quickly enough, and we have seen prices rise, she said previously. The number of new homes being delivered each year has been increasing since 2010, but there is more we can do. A recent report by the Center for Economics and Business Research, commissioned by Santander Mortgages, calculates an extra 146,000 property sales could have taken place over the last 5 years if home movers had not been faced with stamp duty, which was said to be having a stifling impact on the housing market.